Another Crescent Park tenant, single mom Zinat Jahan, says she got laid off in March from her minimum wage job at McDonald's and could not pay rent for 6 months. She says since October, she's now paying her rent in full after she got rehired in a part-time capacity. But at a recent landlord and tenant board hearing, she says she was presented with a repayment plan for her arrears that she can't possibly meet.
It's impossible to pay $1,000 additional with my rent. So my rent is $1,525 and additional $1,000, this is absurd. I cannot.
It sounds like you're willing to pay it back. You just have to do it on your terms. Is that fair to say?
Exactly. We're willing to pay back, but in the way that is, I think it's a flexible way, right?
Sam Nithyananthan from the tenant advocacy group People's Defense Toronto tells me residents are trying to fight back against the corporations that own and operate these apartment complexes. They formed tenants' unions to try to help people navigate the LTB hearing process, many who may not understand how it works. In this era of COVID-19, hearings are being held virtually through Microsoft Teams. They might not even have the technology to attend or not know how to access it, or sometimes might not even get a notice of a hearing at all.
They're being evicted without even being present. And our goal is to make sure that at least they know what's happening. People are pleading with them across the province, not just in the city, but across the province, saying, I have no jobs right now. We're in the middle of a second lockdown. There's a global pandemic going on. And what landlords and the landlord-tenant board want to do is push people out into the streets.
Sam's group has posted portions of these LTB hearings on social media to illustrate some of the barriers tenants are facing. One example he describes is of a child in the hearing trying to negotiate a rent repayment plan for a parent who doesn't speak English. He says the hearings often last less than 5 minutes. Last week alone, he says 2,000 hearings were held.
It's an eviction factory. It's an eviction mill. How else do you run 300 evictions in a day? What we've always known is that the landlord-tenant board was never in favor of tenants. What it's shown over the last 2-3 weeks for us is that that's 100% accurate.
The landlord-tenant board is a quasi-judicial provincial body that oversees and rules on disputes between landlords and tenants. I presented them with a long list of questions on Friday, addressing the complaints of the tenants, but did not hear back in time for broadcast. The tenants want the moratorium on evictions to be reinstated. They also demand rent relief or forgiveness given these unprecedented times.
It's untenable right now. We don't know what the economy is going to look like when this is all over. Tens of thousands of people have lost their jobs. And what we need right now is, one, immediately to stop the bloodbath at the landlord-tenant board.
Keep Your Rent, another group advocating on behalf of tenants, has produced a map with green indicators showing how widespread eviction notices are in the GTA. Another shows the large number of so-called rent evictions and above-guideline rent increases in Toronto. Tenants here say that to add insult to injury, their landlord, Pinedale Properties Limited, which according to their website has a portfolio of 40 properties in Toronto, increased their rent during the height of the pandemic. Not only that, as an enticement to new renters, they are offering them 1 month's free rent, something that longer-term residents say they should be entitled to as well. In East York, I'm Pam Seatle, City News.